and we are just about set for action here at the 2018 Mayor's Trophy Basketball Tournament here at Avenel Middle School. Be here all day for your coverage. I'm Lenny Schnee alongside my father, Scott Schnee. We'll be joined, hopefully, by our illustrious Mayor John McCormick sooner rather than later. Dad, how's it going?
Good. Very good. Good to be here.
This is the 10U division right now. We're getting started. It's going to be Colonia / Merrill Park Patriots versus the Woodbridge Wizards. We'll wait to see who the starters are. I thought they were announcing the starters in the beginning, but they announced everybody. Obviously, all the kids like to get announced.
Yeah, with a small roster, it's probably better for all involved that they announce all the kids.
So the starters getting ready to come out onto the court. Always fun to see the younger kids and all their different rituals that they have. They all have these crazy handshakes with the coaches and fist bumps and bumping chests. And it's, they're already getting into their rituals at such a young age. So starting for Woodbridge, Kevin Arroyo, number 13, Jace Rodriguez, number 22, Shamar Butch, number 9, Grant Lorenza, number 11, and Joe Velez, number 10. For Colonia, Keanu Ortiz, number 1, Dylan Hommel, number 2, Joey Rios, number 3, Tyler Sheila, number 4, and Jaden Del Plaza, number 9. A travel called early here. 8-minute quarters. Taking up the ball for Colonia, it's Tyler Chiola. He passes it down low. That's Ortiz. Ortiz gives it up. It's picked up there by Rodriguez for Woodbridge, and he passes it up to the point guard. That's Butch. Butch down low, Lorenzen. No shot clock here in the 10U division, so they have plenty of time to set the play up. Lorenzen down low in the corner. They keep passing it, going around the horn to the middle, and that is stolen right there. That was Tyler Chiola with the steal. Going down low with it was Colin Croner. And Croner missed that one, sent down low. That was Robbie Florzak, and he couldn't hit that one. Rebound by Woodbridge. And down low, Grant Lorenzen, number 11, gives it over to Arroyo. Arroyo shot, and he scores. Good shot there from the right wing, went off the backboard. And Woodbridge opens the scoring. Colonia looking to get it right back. There's Chiola. Thought he had it. Maybe was looking for a foul, but nothing called, and it's going to be a jump ball. Possession arrow here at this age, and it's going to stay with Colonia. The arrows aren't lit up on the scoreboard, but that's obviously how it's going right now, as it was inbounded right there, and it goes off the leg of Dylan Hommel, and it's out of bounds. So they got the jump ball, but weren't able to do much with it. There's Butch. Takes it up, passes it over to Arroyo. Lorenzen back to Arroyo, and same thing happens on the other side of the court. Right off his foot and out of bounds, and here goes Colonia with the ball. So about 2.5 minutes already gone here, and only 2 points scored. Maybe a theme here in this game.
Seems like there's a little bit of nerves playing a part here right now.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, as that one is laid in right there by Colin Croner, so it's 2-2, but definitely nerves, you know, at this age. They're here. This is one of the bigger tournaments that they're going to play all year. So obviously some nerves. Arroyo sends that one up. It goes high off the top of the net, top of the backboard, excuse me. And it's rebounded by Colonia. There's Tyler Chiola. He gets it back. Chiola puts it up. Off the corner of the rim, doesn't hit. Rebounded there by Florzak. And again a jump ball. Woodbridge is going to get it this time by way of possession arrow. Taking it up is Butch. He passes it to Arroyo. Very similar play every time Woodbridge goes down with the ball. His traveling is called right there. Butch took an extra step that probably wouldn't have gotten called in the professional leagues, but got to teach the kids the rules here as a substitution is made right there. Also something that we noticed, there is a running clock. So as we see, a good screen set right there. Down low with it is Kroner. Passes it out to Chiola. Chiola's got it. He's got a pretty big height advantage on his defender. Florzak again, he takes it in, goes off the rim, picks up his own rebound, puts it back up, and one. Good shot there by Florzak. So he picks up 2 points. And he'll go to the line for a third. The lights are flickering a little bit here in the gym. Keeps messing with me a little bit.
Joshua King just checked in for Woodbridge.
King coming into the game, his first minutes. And right there, he loses that one. It goes out of bounds off the missed free throw. But didn't actually go out of bounds. I thought Colonia grabbed it first, which would mean it was out of bounds, but just went off of him and out. And after the missed free throw, they get to keep possession. Spucci sends it over to Velez. Lorenzen. Much easier with Woodbridge. They have their names in the back of their shirts. Butch. He's got it. Over to Lorenzen. Lorenzen for three. He's got it. Grant Lorenzen, first points of the day. Here's Chiola. Chiola and one. He picked the ball up top of the key. He drove in with his shoulder, and he put that one in like it was nothing. That's 2 points for Chiola, and he'll go and try to hit the third. Something the younger kids a lot of times struggle with the free throws, but we'll see if he can hit this one here. They try to get fancy and emulate what the guys in the NBA do, but we'll see if he just goes for the shot right there. And he does, but it misses. Rebounded, however, by Colonia. I'm sure he'd like to say he did that on purpose. Chiola sends it out. There's Robbie Florzak. Florzak puts it up. Air ball. Rebounded there by Lorenzen for Woodbridge. He's got it. Gives it over to his point guard, Butch. Three's in my way a little bit. Taken in here.
Ooh, in and
shot
out.
Put up. That was Rodriguez. And it just rimmed out. Florzak. Down to 2 minutes remaining here in the quarter. Put up there by Chiola. He misses. Good rebound there by Colonia. And that one goes out of bounds. Woodbridge making some changes. Substitution fairly free at this age. So you're going to see the players moving in and out. Try to keep the starters fresh.
It'll be interesting to see if Woodbridge passing game continues with the subs in there.
Yeah, definitely. Something they've been doing is just going completely around the horn, around the three-point line, and we'll see if they keep that same rotation with the ball, depending on the players, or maybe that is just the type of play they go with their starting five. We shall see. Florzak takes it in. He misses. He's going to have an over-the-back foul called on him when he tried to pick up his own rebound. Liz picks up the ball here off the inbound. Inbound from Borders. Takes it across the half-court line. Nice cross-up. He's got a defender on him. He passes it to Borders. Borders to King. King to Russo. Russo puts it up, and he hits. Very, very long two-pointer. Just about a foot over the three-point line. Taken in, it's Chiola. He's been taking the ball up pretty much every time for Colonia. He passed it off, and that shot couldn't hit. That was Vasquez, number zero. So another jump ball called. Seems to be happening a lot here, and it doesn't surprise me that the ball goes down. The kid's wrestling back and forth for it. Korzak sends it in. Vasquez, he's got it down low. Thinks shot, decides not to. He passes it. Shot put up there. That was Rios, and it's rebounded, but the quarter expires. So first quarter in the books here, and it's 7-6. So it's 7-6 in favor of Colonia. And we'll be back with the second quarter of action in just a couple of minutes.
Get your ass, please, dude. You're not. Yes, I am. No, no, no.
Every day, kids witness bullying.
Why are you stabbing me with it?
No. They want to help, but don't know how. Teach your kids how to be more than a bystander. Visit stopbullying.gov.
And we are back getting ready for the second quarter of action here. It's game one of the 2018 Merritt Trophy basketball tournament. It's the combination of Colonia and Merrill Parker in their third year of playing together, according to Coach Darren Crocker. And they are opposing Woodbridge, the Wizards, their coach, Will Border. Checking in for the first time, it's Gary Rojas, number 8. He inbounds it. Woodbridge has a bunch of subs in from their starting five. Taking it in is Russo. Russo puts it up. Maybe it was foul, but no call. Florsack for Colonia. He's got the ball. He passed it to Chiola. Chiola thought long three, decided not to. He tried to pass it back as he was tripping, but he gives it up. There's Borders to Russo. Not a great pass. Russo picks it up, however, and he just tosses it up. That's an air ball. Some confusion there. I don't think the plan was for him to shoot it, but he didn't see anybody to pass it to, so he just tossed it up.
Yeah, they were a little out of control. I think he made the best of a bad situation.
As that one rims out right there, a shot from Joey Rios. And it's rebounded. Very active coaching we're seeing here on the sidelines. Coach is standing up. Now, hey, put your hands up. Possession arrow. It's going to go to
Woodbridge.
No, it's going to go to Colonia.
Oh, Colonia, my bad.
They have, they haven't swapped sides. They'll swap at half.
That's right. Without the possession arrow, I'm trying to keep track, but it's...
Yeah, I'm not sure why it's not lit up, but obviously that's not our job here, so not going to worry about it. Same thing goes for refereeing. We're not wearing the striped shirt, so if I think there's a foul, it doesn't mean it's necessarily going to get called. I'm sure we'll see it get more competitive as the ages advance. Once we get up to the 14U division, you're going to hear more parents yelling, more coaches yelling, things like that. Florzak takes it up. Thought he had that one. He went coast to coast. Chiola picks up the rebound, and he puts that one in. Tyler Chiola, 4 points. It's more than anybody on the court right now. Eight to seven, your score.
So you notice Woodbridge is looking to pass, so it's basically their game plan, even at this young age.
Yeah, they're very active. The guys that are not, that don't have the ball are very active without it, as Russo put that one up and he can't hit.
A little bit better shot that time, though, from
Absolutely.
Russo.
Yeah, that one looked like it was going in. Is it good? Steal made right there by Rojas. He passes it. He gets it over to his teammate. That was Velez. He couldn't hit. Rebound there by Colonia and Robbie Florsack. Kroner with the ball. Passed it over to Chiola. Chiola put it up, and that one misses. Woodbridge coaching staff not happy right there. They were coming out. He almost ran onto the court right there. He wanted them to come out and put their hands up, and they weren't doing it. And subs are going to happen right now. 3 minutes here into the quarter, 5 minutes remaining.
Yeah, it seemed like a timeout was being called, but they just blew the whistle to let the subs in.
I'm not sure what the timeout rules are. I'd assume they're fairly lenient. They probably get a lot of timeouts at this age, as it's going to be a backcourt violation. I'm not sure if his feet touched, but...
They called it, though.
Referee called it, though. I don't think his feet touched. But, again, not my job. Chiola takes the ball up. This is the 10U division. Colonia only has one 10-year-old. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 9-year-olds and 1 8-year-old. That one's put up there by Kroner. He misses, but he may be going to the line. The referee blew the whistle, but the kids didn't stop playing. So Kroner's going to go to the line for two. And we got a light flickering still here in the gym. I could tell the kids notice it. every time it happens, they start looking up. And
well, these lights are so huge, so large that it's so obvious when
when one goes out.
Yeah.
Puts that one up and he hits. Shot put up, goes off the backboard, rebounded by Colonia. Here goes Sciola. Pass to Kroner. Kroner tried to put that one up. Looks like he's going to the line again. So not a bad game plan for a kid like Kroner, who went to the line right there that last time and hit that free throw like it was nothing. So if he knows he's good at shooting free throws and he can go and draw fouls like that, why not?
What I noticed so far is the Colonia free throw shooting, they don't look like they're trying to be too flashy.
No, not at all.
But they are taking a few seconds and looking at it, and they're not jumping. And a lot of times at this age, the kids still jump.
They try to jump, yeah.
So,
well, you look at this young man right here, Kroner, number 13, who just missed that one. But he's on the larger side as compared to the rest of the kids on the court, so probably stronger as well. When you have a smaller kid right there like Dylan Hommel, number 2 right there, he's on the smaller side, he might have to jump. I know personally myself, I think I jumped till I was about 9 or 10.
Most kids do. And I think Kroner has at least one or two older brothers I remember from years ago coaching baseball, so he's probably been schooled by both dad and
absolutely
the older ones.
If you see here, Butch checked back into the game. That one doesn't hit. Kroner again. Kroner makes the move. He's got it. If he can go up with the left hand, he does. So I think we've been saying his name more than anybody's, and he made a nice move right there. Switched to his offhand, and he put that one up. I knew. I saw he had the opportunity. And a foul's going to be called right there on Vasquez. Going to the line right here is Arroyo.
What's interesting is Kroner seems like he'd be playing center, yet he's bringing the ball up.
Yeah. So. Well, I guess at this age when everyone's still growing, you know, the bigger guys can play any position. As Arroyo hits that one right there, it's not as set in stone, whereas when the kids get to high school, one kid's 6'4", he's obviously going to play center. And, you have the guys that are 5'9", 5'10", that are playing point guard.
Absolutely.
That's in local public school. When you get to the private schools, everybody's 6'3", 6'4". Arroyo misses that one. Kroner picks up the board. I want to apologize. I was saying Florzak before when I was referring to Kroner. I had the numbers mixed up. They're right next to each other on the roster. So I said Florzak a lot, but as he passes that one, rebounded by Ortiz. Might have been an over-the-back call right there. I'm not quite sure. Referees blew the whistle but didn't make any hand signals.
Yeah, no reference as to which number did the violation. So.
Butch right there, he's trying to call a play out, asks for the screen, Borders gives it to him, he gets it down low to Lorenzen. Lorenzen stops dribbling, he might be stuck, but he makes a good pass, and it just goes over. It's going to be a backcourt violation. Smart play right there by, that was number 2, that was Norris Borders. Smart play by him just to get the stoppage in play, similar to like a delayed offsides in hockey.
Absolutely.
When a team, or a high stick call in hockey when you want to go touch up the puck.
Yeah, had the Colonia player touched it first, he might have had a chance to regain possession.
Absolutely. That one goes out of bounds right there. Good play on the Woodbridge defense. Arroyo inbounds it. Gets it over to Butch. Good pass for Lorenzen, but a couple Colonia defenders came out of nowhere, and here goes Kroner again. Kroner loses it. No foul called. He wasn't happy about that one.
That was actually a very good play.
It was a very good defensive play right there. He got it in. I didn't hear any hand slapping. A timeout looks like being called by Woodbridge. I'm assuming there's only one type of timeout in this age group. 30 seconds. There's probably no 30 second or 2 minutes. Probably just 1 minute timeouts. I would assume, unless there's special tournament rules.
We'll have to get a copy of them at halftime.
Definitely. So. If you think about it, there's really not much for the teams to be talking about right now other than just the basic things. Keep your hands up on defense. You know, try to box out under the hoop to get the rebounds. Other than that, you know, the score is 12-8. It's not, you know, there's nothing crazy going on right now.
Good game so far. I mean,
absolutely. Very evenly matched game. And it just shows you the type of young talent that we have here in Woodbridge Township.
Right.
It's why this tournament is here every year in every sport.
Absolutely,
so.
Yep.
And that one is going to be inbounded here by Colonia. The referee telling the young man right there, that's Joey Rios. He was stepping on the line for the inbound. He's telling him, get behind the line. Kroner goes up, another and one. He's got 8 points now. Going for nine.
Yeah, he's doing it all. And oftentimes at this young age, it's, you rely on one or two to do most of the legwork and most of the, you know.
Yeah, a lot of times you have, as he hits that one, make it 9 points. Yeah, a lot of the times I feel like the scoring isn't as balanced as it can get at an older age. But when you look at the other stats, the rebounds, the steals, like, you know, the hustle stats that they like to, that they like to call them, assists, things like that, it's a lot more balanced. The one or two kids just have that shooting touch, that scoring touch, excuse me.
I noticed right there, Colonia seemed to have switched their defense. They were playing more of a man-to-man. They went to a 2-3 right there. And I think the young Woodbridge kids were a little perplexed.
A little flustered.
Yeah, a little perplexed because their passing game stopped working.
Traveling called right there on Ortiz. The Woodbridge coach was right there. He made that call himself before the referees even could.
Sometimes they're pretty obvious.
Especially at this age. You know, you have to be really vigilant with those types of calls because that's the only way that they're going to learn.
Yeah, they don't get the third or fourth step like they do in the NBA.
Yeah, well, and the thing is that a lot of these kids, what they do is they're going to go home tonight, they're going to watch the Nets, the Knicks, or whatever. As Lorenzen puts up a three, can't hit it. King rebounds, puts it right back up, and he hits. They're going to go home, though. They're going to watch LeBron James. King with his first points. And they're going to see him take about six steps on his way to the hole, and certainly not what you want your son necessarily to be doing, son or daughter to be doing. Chiola put that one up. Offensive board there by Rios. Back to Chiola. Chiola, he sends it over to Del Plaza. Del Plaza. Back to Chiola. Chiola tosses it up as the quarter was about to expire. That time really ticks down quickly. I was very... very entranced with the play going back and forth. I lost track of the time. Apologies on not giving a time update.
I fell victim to that too, and it was amazing that a 10-year-old had the wherewithal to, even if the coach is screaming, shoot. We both know, you from playing, me from coaching, that doesn't always resonate to the
no,
kids.
No, absolutely not.
And he got the message and he threw it up. Ill-fated shot, but he still got it off in time.
Yeah, definitely. So we're looking at it. It's 15-10 in favor of Colonia. The clear star of the first half, Colin Kroner, number 13. He picked up 9 points. He also had several rebounds. Another thing that we noticed was the possession arrow being used a lot of fighting back and forth for the ball underneath the hole. Because all the kids are around the same size, so they're all going for the same rebound, and they're all fighting back and forth for the ball. But I'm sure we'll see a lot of the same things going on in the second half. Coach is drawing up some plays. We'll be back in a couple of minutes for the second half of action here from Avenel Middle School.
Don't look at me. Your hair's a bit frizzy today.
Aww.
You should pick that up.
Oh, you're such a dork,
loser.
Here, let me help you with that. Oops.
Every day, kids witness bullying.
Oh, look! Your crush is looking at you.
Poor you.
They want to help, but don't know how.
See, no one here is going to help you, because no one
Teach
likes
your kids
you.
How to be more than a bystander. Visit stopbullying.gov.
All right, and we are back for the second half of action here. Game one of the 2018 Mayor's Trophy basketball tournament. We got a copy of the rules. So,
and we also got the possession hour work, and I just think the scorekeeper didn't realize it because I questioned it. Was it broken? He said, oh, no. So it looks like Woodbridge, right? Woodbridge is the visiting team here, am I correct?
Yes.
Yeah, so the possession arrow to Woodbridge.
And they have switched sides.
Which the possession arrow switches once the ball's put in play, too.
Yeah. As a shot is put up there, that was Rodriguez. Couldn't hit. Kroner here again. I'm not sure if he has left the floor. As he missed that shot, I don't think he's checked out the entire game. So we're going to take a look at the rules really quick, as timeouts were something that I was a little bit confused about. So the first two rounds, you have two 30-second timeouts per half, and they don't carry over. So Coach Crocker, however, for the championship game, you're going to have three full and two 30-second timeouts for the games. Three full and two 30-second timeouts. So take advantage of those late in the game. I'm sure we all know that the last 2 minutes of a basketball game can last insane amounts of time in comparison to what it looks like on the scoreboard. Good steal there by Lorenzen. No scoring here. First minute. Went off the foot, but he still picked it up. They lose possession right there, so I guess it kind of just went right back to them. Taking the ball up here for Colonia, Sciola. Gives it to Kroner. Kroner's going to get called for traveling. He's not happy about that, but referees are being very on top of things like that. They haven't really called any double dribbles. I see a lot of the kids dribble with the hand over. You know, you see it in the NBA a lot, but I guess they're not trying to call that too much. They'd be whistling the play every single time. It's a good bank shot is taken right there. And it hits. That was Kevin Arroyo.
Yeah, that play you're referring to, or that dribble, is when I was a kid, was called the carry. And I guess over the years it's evolved.
I don't think it really, yeah, like I don't really hear that said much anymore.
No, and you don't see it called too much either.
Rodriguez, nice spin move, but he travels on that. If he would have just bounced the ball off the ground, he would have had another two steps, and then he probably could have put that one up. Probably would have had a good chance to score as well. 15-12 the score, 5:45. Kind of tough to give you a time with the running clock, but that was what it was when I just said it. Now 5:40 remaining here in the quarter. Good pass sent down low, but Lorenzen gets a nice steal. See if he sends it up to Rodriguez. He doesn't. Lorenzen goes right up for the layup, and he hits. That's 5 points for Grant Lorenzen. He hit a nice three early in the first quarter. And he's one of the bigger players on the floor, so he gets a lot of rebounds as well. Shot put up by Colonia. Good steal there on the rebound.
Oh, nice pass.
And a beautiful pass sent up there.
Oh.
Nearly another two for Rodriguez, but he just misses like a quarterback right there. That ball was sent. Not sure what Coach Borders was looking for right there, but he seemed to be upset with the referee.
Not really sure what the call was. There was some confusion there on whose possession it was going to be.
The referees aren't every play making the hand signals. So that one, whistle blows.
I think the referees are pacing themselves. They're in for a long day.
Yeah, they certainly are. This is Tom Medler and George Banos. George Banos, he'll be around for next game. So it looked like there was going to be a steal, but Coach Darren Crocker gets his player to call a timeout, or maybe the coach called a timeout. You know, very smart play right there.
We've got some rules with the clock here if you want to give everybody that.
Yeah, absolutely. So we're taking a look. We have the Mayor's Trophy rules. There's 13 specific rules. I'm certainly not going to read them all. But other than that, similar to whereas Little League has local rules, and then they refer to Little League here, they refer to high school rules if they are not specified. So there's 4 8-minute quarters with a running clock, and the clock's going to stop on whistles in the last 2 minutes of the half and on foul shots once shooters receive the ball from the referee. So the clock doesn't always run.
It appeared to run, but again, you corrected me.
I feel like it ran in the end of the second half. I mean, in the end of the first half, but we could also just have not been paying attention well enough.
Well, it certainly ran to zero quick because we were both stunned when the buzzer went off.
So the Colonia coach is getting a warning on the bench, being a little bit loud, as Kroner tried to send that one back court, but, oh, and a good steal from behind right there. Poking the ball out from behind was Hommel. Kroner tried to put that one up. Thought he was fouled, but he wasn't. Arroyo makes a nice move. Arroyo, he puts it up.
Ooh.
Oh, and it just rims out. Picks up his own rebound, and it's a possession arrow. Him and Kroner going back and forth. Two 13s fighting for the ball. It looked a little more violent than I think it was, just because they both tried to rip it away at the same time and they both fell down. So immediately a lot of the parents shot up, but the kids didn't seem too worried, so I guess that's all really we have to worry about. Sent out to Rodriguez. Rodriguez puts it up off the backboard, and he hits a little bit further than a free throw. That's a two-pointer. Pretty long one, but nonetheless, 2 points. When you were this age, was there a three-pointer, or had that not been a thing yet? And I'm not trying to call you old. I'm just asking a serious question.
Well, when I was 10, the only three-pointers existed in the old ABA, which many of your younger listeners may not know what that was. But the NBA did not have a three-pointer, nor did college.
So what was it, about 78, something like that, 77? Or was it even later than that?
You're being kind. When I was 10, you would have been 75 to 76.
Okay. So.
And the ABA was just about to go out of business at that point. In 76, I believe, 77, they did the merger.
They took four teams, I believe it was.
Four to six. Not that anybody cares, but it was the Denver Nuggets, the New York Nets at the time, the Pacers, and at least one of the San
Antonio Spurs.
Yeah. And the ABA played with that old red, white, and
with
blue
the red,
ball.
White, and blue ball. Yeah, you see in the Dr. J highlights, his Kroner's here at the line. He hits the first one. No surprise there. He's got 10 points now. So he's the only player in double digits. He's got 10 of his team's 16 points. 16 up is the score, and he misses that one. Tried to rebound it himself. Man, he got there quick. It bounced off the rim and to the right, as you saw, and he tried to... Wow, that was unbelievable. He almost got that.
And the fact is, he's one of the 9-year-olds you mentioned, so
yeah.
He's got a bright future if he sticks with basketball.
Absolutely. Hopefully he continues to grow, because I feel like that was probably my issue as to why I'm not, you know, in the NBA right now.
Yeah, that was probably the only issue.
Yeah, the only issue. Vasquez picks that one up, Colonia is going to keep their possession. They're going to inbound it from below the baseline.
Much easier with the possession arrow up for us.
Absolutely. It really is.
They got two state-of-the-art scoreboards
beautiful
here.
Beautiful scoreboards, yes. As that one's inbounded, Woodbridge is going to get possession on that. 16 up is the score, just 2 minutes. We're at the two-minute warning. But it was at the end of the half that the clock is going to stop, so the 2 minutes is going to keep running.
Right. And it looks like if the game holds true to what it's been so far for nearly three quarters, that last 2 minutes could take a while.
Absolutely. Kroner puts that one up. He misses. Offensive board picked up there. Kroner's going to get another offensive rebound, and may call an over-the-back call right there. Kroner did push a little bit. And he's a little bit upset about that one. Don't blame him. Lorenzen here with the ball. Tries to send it up the middle. Not a smart pass right there. Picked up here by Ortiz. Nearly went over the half court line. Just kept it in. Big shot put up there by Kroner. He misses. It's back to him. He's going to possibly take it again. He drives in. He puts it up and he hits. Kroner two more. It's 12 now. 18 to 16, under a minute remaining in the third quarter. Arroyo, long three. He might have that. He hits it, nothing but net. Devin Arroyo, he's got 8 points on the afternoon. The morning, shall I say. We're not even at the afternoon yet. Here's Chiola.
Ooh.
Took one too many steps. Looked good.
It looks smooth, too, which means
very
he probably
smooth.
Watches a lot of NBA because that was too good. It was a purposeful slow motion roll to the basket.
I just noticed Colonia there. All the kids have the same shoes. Interesting. They all match. That's a good shot sent up there by Rodriguez. Was it three? It was, and Woodbridge takes the lead. This might be their first lead of the morning. 21-18 in favor of Woodbridge. 2 seconds. Shot put up, and it doesn't hit. Another shot was put up. He picked up an offensive rebound there, Ortiz. I'm not sure if he got it up in time, but that also missed nonetheless. 21-18, your score. Top scorer is Colin Kroner with 12 for Colonia. And we're looking at 8 for Kevin Arroyo on Woodbridge. Also got 5 for Grant Lorenzo. We'll be back. Fourth quarter of action coming up next.
Morning, Gary. We are GetSchooled.com. You want a college education, don't you?
You know you do.
yeah, but I don't know where to start. That's why we're here. We're free, Handsome.
Oh, I think we're breathtaking.
And here to guide you through every step of the way, starting with attendance. Gary, financial aid forms.
Biology homework, Chief. I got this.
Is that Bran?
Colleges love extracurricular activities.
Chess really isn't my thing.
I got this. Doesn't matter. Go ahead. Picking a college, man. You and us. Go together like tacos and Tuesday.
And I love tacos.
Fire and ice.
Those don't really go together.
Go to getschool.com for more info.
Back for the final quarter of action in game one of this year's Mayor's Trophy basketball tournament. Again, it's Colonia Merrill Park taking on Woodbridge. It's the Patriots of Colonia Merrill Park and the Wizards of Woodbridge. Arroyo right here in front of us. He's going to inbound it. He's going to give it to his teammates, Borders. Arroyo down low. Rodriguez, he was looking for three. Doesn't take it. Arroyo takes it in. He just overshot that one a little bit. It was right on target, but it was just about a foot too far.
It's going to be interesting to see how Colonia operates without Kroner in the game.
Yeah, absolutely. He was getting a little bit frustrated at the end of that last quarter. He was looking very upset. So it's good, probably a good move by the coaching staff to pull him out, give him a couple minutes of a break, and then put him back in for the last few minutes when they really need him in crunch time, as he's obviously the top scorer. Taking it up is Della Plaza. Della Plaza's small, but he's got quick feet.
Good hands, too. I see dribbling with both hands. Doesn't even look awkward.
Very, yeah. A lot of times you see at this age, they're very focused on one hand, but he was crossing it over. Lorenzen, he picks it off, and he goes back up, tries to hit the layup. A little bit too hard off the backboard.
Looks like he might have been fouled. The Woodbridge coach was asking for it, but
yeah.
I think they're letting them play. I mean, it is a championship game, even at the 10U level, so the refs are trying their best.
Della Plaza, and yeah. Definitely difficult for the refereeing staff as Rios hits that one. For the couple of referees, you know, you have to be careful what you call and what you don't call at this age because you get a lot of parental involvement, a lot of coaching involvement. So you really have to decide at the beginning of the game, hey, we're going to call everything or, hey, we're going to let them go a little bit. And obviously they chose the latter. Rodriguez across. Good pick right there by Ortiz. And he's going to put it up, but he can't hit. Open layup right there, but he doesn't hit. But the coaching staff, I'm noticing the coaching staff for Colonia a little bit more on the quiet side. Foul called right there. Couple of subs being made. For Woodbridge, Russo checks in. Sean Russo. Butch tries to put that one up, but he's knocked down.
Kroner off the bench. He'll be checking in at the next stoppage.
That one's put up there by Rios. He doesn't hit, or Ortiz, excuse me. And it goes off the head of Rodriguez and out of bounds.
That was a good
play. Looks like Colonia's going to keep possession.
Good defensive play by Colonia right there. They had him right on the baseline.
But, I thought Colonia was going to keep possession, but I guess it went off of Colonia.
That's what it looked like to me, too.
But obviously we're across the court, so our vision not quite as good. Looked like a travel right there. Wasn't called. Lorenzen's got it. Gives it to Rodriguez. Rodriguez pushed off with his arm right there. I'm not sure if they're going to call that. But maybe they're calling it on the defense, on the floor.
Shamar Butch bringing the ball up for Woodbridge. He's got such quick feet that the refs might have missed that just because the...
Yeah, because he's moving so quickly.
They are. They're moving so fast, and he's got such little skinny legs at that age.
Rodriguez puts it up. Off target. He can't hit. Here's Kroner. He's back in the game. 4 minutes and 50 seconds remaining here in the final quarter. It's 21-20 in favor of Woodbridge. It's a championship game here, so...
Oh.
That one, good move there by Chiola. Went for more of a finger roll, which you don't always teach the kids at this age because they're not exactly as strong with the one hand, but he almost hit that one. Another check-in. It's Vasquez coming in for some size for Colonia.
Obviously, I have a set inbound play right here.
They tried it before right in front of us, and it was picked off, but this time Chiola was a little bit closer.
And you notice Kroner was inbounding the ball, so he seems to be the go-to guy for them.
Yeah, he inbounds it, but then he immediately runs right to where he passed it to so he can go pick it up and start the play. Because when you don't have a shot clock, you know, he gets it back. That's when the play starts.
Absolutely.
If this were even college, it's traveling his car right there. Even if this were college, where it's, what, 30 seconds now, I believe? You know, once that happens, now you're down to 23 seconds, and you have a lot less time to set up a play.
Absolutely.
So you see a lot of set plays here at this age. As Kroner's going to take that one, and he hits. Kroner now 14 points on the morning. You see he's settled in a lot compared to last half as a traveling calls there on Butch. He was tripped up a little bit, and he forgot to dribble when he regained his footing. Coach Borders telling the kids to calm down now that they've given up the lead. It's 22-21. You got to keep settled. Hopefully one kid doesn't try to do it all on his own.
I believe that might have been Woodbridge's first lead of the game, but they've been in it the whole time.
Kroner nearly stepping out of bounds right here in front of us. Can they stay closer to us? It's a lot easier to see their numbers as we see Chiola. He takes it in. He passes it. He faked the pass. He put it up. He's going to go to the line for two. So an opportunity to advance the lead.
Yeah, so the clock does, in fact, it's the first time we actually took notice of it.
Stopping for a free throw.
Yeah, once the referee hands the ball to the shooter, the scorekeeper stops the clock.
Misses free throw number one. So something that I'm reading in the rules and I didn't notice is that there's no press. So full court press for sixth grade and up. Fourth grade boys can only press in the last 3 minutes. Oh, so pressing is going to happen now. This is going to be the first inbound in the final 3 minutes. You can press now.
Well, we'll see. We'll see if they take advantage of it.
So we'll see if they take advantage or if that's a rule that a really smart coach will definitely have, especially
right there.
You see it. Yep.
Colonia right away pressing.
That one's put up there. Doesn't hit. Possession arrow. Woodbridge is going to get the ball. Now, it doesn't surprise me that Colonia knows the rules. Coach Darren Crocker is on the WTYRC board, and he's
actually the president.
He's the president of the WTYRC board, and he helps make the rules. So, obviously, he knows the rules.
Well, you would hope that.
Distinct advantage.
At this level of play, no matter what.
Oh, absolutely. I'm sure Coach Borders over there is completely aware of that rule as well. As Colonia right there. It was a good job by Ortiz. He drew some contact, but he traveled before the contact happened, so that call comes first. Butch taking the ball up. He passes it down low. Probably an ill-advised pass there to Russo, but he got it, and foul happens.
It'll be interesting to see how the coaches coach for the remainder of the game. Under 2 minutes to go, the clock is stopping at every whistle, and I'm sure they have a couple of timeouts left each. We haven't tracked the timeouts specifically.
Yeah, there's only been one timeout this half, and it was from Colonia.
So they should each have a couple of timeouts left minimum, and it's a tight game, so let's see what happens.
Minute 42 on the clock. Chiola over to Kroner. Kroner thought three, decided against it. Probably the smart play. He's got Butch on him. Butch is dialed in right here. He's got one hand out, one hand up. Kroner makes the move around him. He puts it up. Ooh. Can't hit. Rebound. Ortiz. Offensive board. Ortiz takes it around. The beauty of no shot clock is you can reset. Timeout called there by Coach Crocker. Colonia was a little bit rattled after that first play didn't work. But they're going to have a second opportunity here.
Probably a good timeout because
absolutely,
they're up by one, and they had the ball underneath, maybe taking a chance on a three-second call. Kroner was way outside; they weren't going to be able to get him the ball, which obviously is the idea on almost every play. And I don't blame him. At this age, like you said before, when you have that one more talented kid, for lack of a better word, he's obviously going to be the go-to guy.
Yeah, you want to draw up a play. If you're going to try to go to a kid like Kroner, which they probably will, you want to draw up a play to get him the ball. But then it gets really obvious, like in the NBA when they're down by one, you know, and you're playing the Cavaliers, you put three guys on LeBron James.
Absolutely. So it'll be interesting to see how Woodbridge defends now when Kroner's got the bulk of the points and he handles the ball the bulk of the time. So I do notice they got the little guy, De Plaza, I believe his name is. He's inbounding the ball. So different play set up there. Kroner was on the outside, was the second one.
Woodbridge was not overly aggressive there on the defense. Chiola down low, gives it to Ortiz. Ortiz can't hit, picks up his own rebound.
It was a good pass.
And there goes Woodbridge. Here's Sean Russo. Russo, he's by himself. Looked like he may have taken one too many steps, but he misses nonetheless. We're down to a minute. Here's Kroner. Next stoppage will bring you the overtime rules, just in case they come into play. There's a travel right there, so I'll give you the overtime rules really quickly as Woodbridge is going to inbound. No press here by Colonia. Coach telling him, stay back. So overtime is going to be 2 minutes if it happens. You get one timeout each, and the clock stops on whistles only in the last minute. And then they'll play extra one-minute overtimes, and the clock will stop on all whistles inside 30 seconds if it were to continue. Colonia makes a good defensive play right there. They get the ball back. Nearly a half-court violation right there. Kroner is being defended hard. 13-on-13 action. Chiola down low. Ortiz on the baseline. Ortiz blocked there by Arroyo. He got a little bit of the hand, and Ortiz is going to go to the line. 22-21, 23 seconds remaining. Here's a beautiful opportunity if you're Colonia to make it a three-point lead.
The Woodbridge coach was upset about that call, as most coaches would be, but it was highly unlikely that the kid didn't touch the arm.
Ortiz misses, yeah. Especially, you just think in a situation like this and in how tight the game is, they're just trying to stop him from scoring. They're not really too worried about if they're hitting the ball or not. Ortiz puts that one up. He misses both. That second one almost looked like he was trying to get an offensive rebound out of it. I'm not sure if he was being a little slick. But
well, he didn't hit the rim, which, as you know, that causes the ball to be inbounded from the side. So no chance for a rebound, unfortunately, if he was. I don't know. I wouldn't know. I didn't see any gesturing from the Colonia bench to do that.
Neither did I.
He was one of the – we were commending the foul shooting earlier in the game, and not to knock a 9- or 10-year-old boy, but that wasn't one of the more one of the better-looking free-throw attempts of the day. So maybe you're right. Maybe they were trying to get the rebound. They do have some tall kids underneath. Plus, they could kill some clock right there in their end of the court.
Absolutely. So, in the timeout right now, it's 23.7 seconds. It's 22-21 in favor of Colonia. Very low-scoring game. Sometimes you see these 10U games get up in the 40s, but...
Just to note, the possession arrow is for Woodbridge, and Woodbridge is going to have the ball. So Woodbridge has the ball and will get the ball again on any type of tie-up.
Yeah, and a shot wins this game for Woodbridge. If they hold possession for the final 23 seconds, a shot wins it.
Right.
So I'm not sure who they'll go to. Maybe Arroyo. Lorenzen hit a three-pointer earlier in the game. He only took one three-pointer and he hit it. So he's a pretty good long shooter. I saw him a lot in warm-ups hitting a lot of long shots. So, whereas with Colonia, you know they have one go-to guy.
Colonia is pressing. Colonia is pressing.
Pressing here, Chiola. You don't blame them. You know, you press a little bit. Try to fluster them. Butch took a couple of steps. And, oh, man, they're calling that on the floor.
That's a tough call.
That's a very tough call. I thought the shot was going up. So did the coaching staff. Here's Rodriguez. He puts it up. Rodriguez, he hits. Woodbridge takes the lead. 9 seconds remaining. 23-22 in favor of Woodbridge. Colonia, Chiola over to Kroner. And Coach Crocker calls timeout. 5.5 remaining on the clock. They might add another second or two. I feel like the scorekeeper may have... not hit it right away as soon as the whistle was blown, but we'll see about that.
Doesn't appear that the refs are even approaching the table.
No, I'm not sure that the referees are necessarily paying attention that well to the exact, you know, the point, 5.5, 5.8. I know when you get up to the higher level, like a someone on the coaching staff. That's their job.
Well, also here with two refs,
an assistant coach.
With two refs, I realize the game doesn't move as fast at the younger level. But two refs, they're each trying to watch a specific thing, and the clock is probably not one of them, unless something's blatant. And if it's blatant, they'll notice it. It'll just be obvious. So.
And in football, you always hear them, please reset the game clock to this, please reset the game clock to that, and that's because they have so many officials on the field.
It's also a slower-moving game.
Absolutely.
With a reset after every play.
They have the runoff depending on what the flag is and things like that.
All right, basketball, I mean, other than hockey, basketball is one of the faster, if not the fastest-moving game. So it's you give the refs credit.
So this would be quite the comeback for Woodbridge, who were down by as many as six at one point.
This might be their only their second lead of the game, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, second or third. Inbound, Ortiz. He puts it up and he can't hit it. Time's going to expire and Woodbridge wins. The Wizards of Woodbridge are your 10U Marist Trophy champions for 2018. Ortiz had the opportunity to advance the lead from the free throw line. Couldn't do it. He had the opportunity there to take the W, and he just missed that one as well. Outstanding effort by Colonia and Woodbridge. They're in the high five line right now. Trophy ceremony to follow. What an outstanding effort by the two teams. The trophy ceremony as well as the game's MVP.
What I noticed right there is they could not get the ball to Krona. And
no,
that was
they
the
couldn't.
Obvious thing.
So Jace Rodriguez discussing with the town rec officials, it looks like Jace Rodriguez is going to be named the game's MVP. He had the game-winning shot, or the lead-taking shot, shall I say, for Woodbridge. Not the game winning. It wasn't a last second or something like that, a buzzer beater.
In a sense, it was the game winner because it put them ahead and they stayed ahead.
Yeah.
And it was a big shot and a lot of pressure at this age to even get the ball in your hands with 5 or 6 seconds left. So we give them a lot of credit. Now we're going to have the trophy presentation.
So trophy presentation to come up. Final score was 22-21. Outstanding, 23-22, excuse me.
Yeah, we
outstanding
have
effort there.
Vice President of Woodbridge, the WTYRC, the Township Youth Recreation Council, Kristen Rhoda, who handles winter sports. And we also have the Recreation Director for the Township, Vito Simaluca, along with the Deputy Director, Brian Molnar, out here. And, of course, Darren Crocker is wearing two hats today. He's a coach at Colonia 10U, but he's also the President of the WTYRC. So he's actually going to stay with the team for this ceremony. I'm sure the rest of the day he'll be involved in the handing out of the plaques and trophies. So
amazing effort by both teams. The score was so close the entire game. You would think when you have one, when you have one player who's scoring 14 points, you would think that the score would be a lot separate. But nonetheless, good victory there for Woodbridge. And that is going to do it here for the
Helping us out handing out trophies today is going to be the Director of Recreation, Vito Simaluca, and the Assistant, Brian Molnar. First for Colonia, Robbie Florzak. Head coach Darren Crocker, assistant coach Edward Flores, and assistant coach Nick Shine. And the players, Robbie Florzak. Dylan Hommel. Nick Vasquez. Tyler Chiola. Jaden Della Palazza. Colin Kroner. Joey Rios. Keanu Ortiz. I'm just going to introduce the rest of our players that were not able to play today. RJ Wortman, Braden Garcia, Colin Garonsky, Tyler Montgomery, also Julian Jones, who was not able to attend. Okay. Now for Woodbridge, first place. Coach Will, Coach Gary, Coach Joel. Now the players, number 13, Kevin Arroyo. JC Rodriguez. Shamar Butch. Grant Lorenzen. Joel Velez Jr. Norris Borders. Joshua King. Gary Rojas. Sean Russo. And the MVP of today's game, number 22, Jace Rodriguez. Thank you to both teams. Thank you to Mr. Molnar, Mr. Simaluka. They need a picture of both teams, so don't go anywhere.